Hello everyone and welcome to Road to Sundays. Before the episode starts, I would like to introduce the exact concept of this new show. We will be following one athlete from his senior season in high school all the way to his final season of his choosing, of course, in college. And then, of course, finding out if he will make it to playing on Sundays. This 5 years or so, however much it takes, we are following quarterback / corner Tanner Patrick, the Iron Man out of Cincinnati, Ohio. Thank you folks for tuning in, and we will now go to the beginning of the inaugural episode of Road to Sundays. Welcome everyone to Cincinnati, Ohio, as we're quickly into the game here of Tanner Patrick, the 5'11", 175 quarterback / corner. Tanner Patrick, of course, playing for Cincinnati High School's Hounds here, and on defense, he has been one of their top guys since his freshman year, coming into play for an injured teammate. As it's 3rd-and-13 here, and he just plays solid coverage right there, allowing his team to get there quickly. Alliance, though, not known to be a tough opponent here in the Ohio area. Though now we go to offense, and this is the deadliest part of Tanner Patrick's game. He's not built to be a prototype quarterback, but his speed is killer. 72 yards, first play on offense. And this is why he originally was here to play only quarterback. Now we go back to defense on a 3rd-and-16 for Alliance, and nice man coverage sticking with his receiver, leading to the sack. As it's 2nd-and-8 now on offense with great field position, what does Patrick do here? Stays in the pocket, throws toward the outside to Michael Weisbecker, his big tight end, for 17 yards and a first down. He doesn't have the greatest arm, but scouts love his ability to play, as they like to call it, Johnny Manziel-style football. As there once again, we see him dropping back, missing his man. As Patrick, I will agree, has those Johnny Manziel intangibles. The only question is, will he be the off-field issue that Manziel truly was? As Craig Ostrander is found 19 yards into the end zone. First touchdown of the day through the air for Cincinnati. As we'll see it here again, Patrick having all day to throw. And of course, as I said, Alliance not known to be one of the powerhouse teams here in the state of Ohio. But now back to defense. Patrick in man coverage. A run though goes right up the gut. And so far, Patrick has yet to be challenged on the outside. That will take us to the end of the first quarter. Patrick really showcasing here early. As now we start the second quarter here, folks, and Tanner Patrick going to play in the flats. They send the run, and look at Patrick breaking off of the guard, and a big tackle for a loss of 4 by Tanner Patrick. And it's one thing a cornerback needs to be able to do is stop the run. And there's a good example of it right there. However, Patrick is much more known for his coverage abilities. He didn't know where to go, it looked like, there to begin. However, Brandon Whitaker makes the catch 24 yards. However, away from Patrick. Now, back to the run game goes Alliance. And still away from Patrick as he's being held on his own with this one receiver. Now across the middle, and Patrick was in the vicinity, just not there quick enough to make the play on the ball. As now back to offense, Cincinnati's lead now 11. Patrick rolling to his right, and it looked like he wanted to make something happen, but gets caught by this, I believe that was a corner, just a little too quickly. But it's a big 3rd-and-16 now here on offense for Tanner Patrick. He throws deep, finds Gio Soria. That's 23 yards and a first down. A big play there by Patrick. He takes a big shot too. As first and 10 now, are we going to see some more of the option with him as he drops back and he's taking off. Quickly rolls to his right and quickly gets 17 yards for another Cincinnati first down. The Hounds driving here on offense. The 5'11 monster that is Tanner Patrick taking his blows here tonight. It's a 17-yard pass there to Thin Nguyen and another big shot taken. As first and 10 now with under 2 minutes remaining in the half. Deep ball to the end zone and Weisbecker stretches out for it. Great placement by Tanner Patrick. The young gun of Patrick only has to go up from here. He doesn't have the arm strength of a guy like an Aaron Rodgers or someone you would think of like that in the pros. But with time, I think this kid could become something big at the quarterback position. However, there has been talk from his family about him wanting to play corner at the collegiate level. We'll see what he decides to do along with the schools that are interested in him this year. As third and four now here as Patrick was just trying to defend the flats and the rest of his team does what's needed. Second and three now back on offense for Patrick. He's looking deep as no one around Nguyen. And that is a deep touchdown, but the arm strength once again shown how he wasn't able to just drive it. Nguyen had to really spin around to get the ball again, and that once again shows he doesn't have the biggest arm. But hell of a good throw by Tanner Patrick, sending that ball deep and putting it on the board. As that is the end of the first half, we'll be back with more. As it is the start of the second half of play, Tanner Patrick taking off here on the option, and he pitches it at the last second to Bill Wilson, and Wilson's got running room. That's a big 53-yard gain, a risky time to pitch it, if you ask me, by Tanner Patrick, but it works out. Second and one now as Patrick looking for an open man. He decides to take off, sliding to save himself, and a big first down near the five. Second and goal here. What do they have in mind? As there's the handoff. No, it's the option. And the second rushing touchdown of the day for Patrick. As it's second and five here, we haven't seen Patrick be challenged here today. He's stuck in man coverage there well. But there's the throw to the outside to Ben Palmer, the running back for Alliance. 18 yards and a first down. Third and nine here for Patrick as he's in the flats again. He's just waiting for his number to be called, but that's an interception by his fellow teammate, McLeod. A nice play on the ball there as McLeod makes a good play. And now back on offense is Patrick, but he gets stuffed, a big sack there. Once again, that shows what could be a weakness for Patrick come his college game if he chooses the quarterback position. Patrick now dropping back here, second and 17, rolling to his left, but he finds Michael Weisbecker, and Weisbecker showcasing himself here tonight on the inaugural episode of Road to Sundays. Tanner Patrick, though, a great stat line, 213 with three touchdowns. As this third quarter is coming to a close, Patrick drops back again. Closing is the rush as Patrick's able to avoid it, gets a nice block on the outside, and that is how you make something out of nothing. As that will take us to the final quarter of play here, as Tanner Patrick has been on fire tonight. First and goal now here to start the fourth. And I would not be surprised to see another passing touchdown as there it is, Craig Ostrander for the second time tonight. 6-yard touchdown from Patrick. And from what I've been hearing is the night is done for the first string offense, which means all we will see left of Tanner Patrick is on defense. As Patrick now in zone coverage here from the looks of things. Playing the deep ball. No, now going after the running, or I'm sorry, the receiver Josh Johnson. As it's second two now here, Patrick in the flats. He's able to get to him, but can't take the running back down. That right there is not going to impress the scouts. I can guarantee you of that. He needs to wrap up and tackle well if he wants to go to a big name school at corner. As that ball is underthrown, and Patrick was nearly in the exact place to make a big play. But that's all she wrote, folks, for this first week of high school football for the Cincinnati Hounds. As Tanner Patrick, a hell of a showing on the offensive side of the ball. Defensively, a very quiet day. But nonetheless, he is still the player of the game for the Hounds and a big, good showing for the young man. As now, folks, we're going to go in and take a look at what schools may be interested in this young quarterback-cornerback hybrid known as Tanner Patrick, as once again we take a look at the highlights here. Cincinnati, of course, wins over Alliance 42-3. And it's set from the sounds of things that I've been hearing, Purdue, Pitt, and Toledo have shown extreme interest in Tanner Patrick at the quarterback position. At corner, a little lower down the radar, Western Kentucky, Western Michigan, and Eastern Michigan. But next week, the Hilltoppers will be coming to face the Hounds as they are still home.